So this is an opening speech by our pastor. Apostle, no longer the floor is yours. I have our floor.
Thank you. Everybody for coming. Today's program has a long story, but I don't think we have the time space to be able to do that. I'm just going to say a very short address. I hope it will stir our hearts for the next 5 years on our attendance tonight. Dear friends, Chairman of Education, members of the High Table, the clergy, leaders of various NGOs, leaders of various associations, President of Ghana Union Finland, members of various migrant communities, and our host native friends. On behalf of the leadership of the Church of Chronicles, the board members and team leaders of Princess, on my behalf, on behalf of the team, you are welcome. I pray that the peace of God will be with you and with us, with your families, and your respective organizations for taking the time and the trouble to be with us in these troubling times. Today's gathering and the launching of Princess Finland is a clarion call, a call to rise up and rebuild. In the midst of this global medical crisis of biblical proportion, COVID-19, and its attendant economic impact that is reckoning on us, if there is any cry or any call from any community or any quarters, it should be a call to rise and rebuild. The call was made originally by Nehemiah, a native of Jerusalem, who found himself in another land. And he saw the need to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem for his people and for posterity. Because the call and the cause were loud, necessary, important, and timely, God came in and they were able to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem, which represents their safety and security. The call to rise and rebuild proposes the need to move beyond the indifference, the complacency and the laxity which tend to slow down progress and development of our people and humanity in general. Our call is to rebuild not a physical wall, but a wall which ensures a safety net and the dignity of individual human beings created in the image of God to live a dignified life not based on his or her ability to afford the basic necessities of life. It is a call to ensure the poor and the needy is not left out of the daily distribution of the necessities of life. It is a call to make sure the poor and the needy does not suffer ill health just because they cannot afford a surgery. It is a call to ensure the poor is emboldened to rise up and rebuild his or her life. It is a call to bridge the digital divide of the haves and the have-nots. It is a call to ensure the poor child in society has a toy to play and to develop himself or herself. Remember, one poor individual makes us a poor society. So let us rise and rebuild our needy individuals. Let us rise and rebuild our needy families. Let us rise and rebuild our needy communities. Let us rise and rebuild a cohesive society to leave a lasting legacy for prosperity. Pensos, Finland, seek to do that. With this in mind, I call on all and sundry church leaders, community leaders, members of the migrant community, native citizens of Finland, and all stakeholders. Let us rise and rebuild for the support and the assistance of humanity here in Finland and abroad. I trust that you will heed to this clarion call to rise and rebuild with Pensos Finland. And on this note, I declare Pensos event open In the name of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God bless you. Amen.